is everybody this morning?
Wonderful.
Oh, that's convenient. You can ask me how I am.
How are you?
I'm wonderful, thank you. Glad you asked. Let me tell you something. I am one of these guys who, I don't fish. I have always said, I don't understand why people would go out and waste their time fishing when they could be out on the golf course. But I know there are some people who agree with me about that, like Bob Nimitz. I'm sure he agrees with me. So does Arne Nicholson. I can see him up there sitting and saying, yeah. I said, no. Oh, that's, he's doing like that. Maybe not. Well, I'll tell you what, I just don't fish. But a couple years ago, I decided that I would go on a fishing trip. And so I did actually go on a fishing trip, and I want to show you what happened when I went on this fishing trip. First of all, here's a picture. There were about six of us guys that were on a boat, and we went out fishing, and here's what we caught. Can you see that?
No. Okay.
You can't see that?
No.
Oh, yeah, what are those white fish right there that are kind of laying out there? Can you see those? Those are called halibut. And then there are, and I caught two of those. And then we had these rockfish, and they're the smaller ones there. And we reached, got four of those. And then we also caught some little cod there. But you know, the interesting thing about these halibut, was that you could catch one that was over 11 inches, and you could have one that was under 11 inches, but you had to have one of each for those two. Well, I caught my first one, and it was over 11 inches, and then I caught two or three others, and they were over 11 inches, so I had to throw them back. And then I finally caught the one that was less than 11 inches. So then we went catching rockfish. So I went down and I caught a couple of rockfish. And when I had my second rockfish on the line, it came in and I was reeling it in and so forth. And we got kind of close to the boat, and all of a sudden the line got really heavy. And we discovered that there was another fish on my line. And we were able to, it was eating my rockfish. And we were able to get it into the boat. And this fish that I caught, you know, fishermen will tell you, I caught a fish this big, right? Right. Well, I caught a fish, that second fish was this big. You believe me? Okay, I'm glad. Wait, you don't believe me?
You couldn't catch that big of a fish.
Huh?
You couldn't catch that big of a fish.
I couldn't catch that big of a fish. Yeah, and those are huge, aren't they?
I got a picture
of the fish I caught. And as you can see, it's almost, yeah, see it? Whoa, what is that? Wow. Huh? And you didn't believe me when you said I had to catch a fish that big. It was that big. And you know what about that fish? It would have made two or three of you mad. I can tell you. But you know what happened? The captain, who's there in that picture with me, he said, "Oh, unfortunately, that's the best eating cod you can ever catch. Unfortunately, it's not the right season, and I had to throw that fish back." Oh, it's true. It's true. Well, what does that have to do with anything? It's a nice story. You know, there was a passage in the Bible where Jesus was talking about, he was going and he was collecting his followers. And he said, "Come with me and I'll make you fishers of men." Now, what did he mean by that? Yeah, I tell you what he meant was, you know, we need to go and be like Christ and ship people so that they will come to him and they'll understand God's love. But the really nice thing about making fishers of men is when I had to throw those halibut back in, and when I had to throw that lean cod back in, that doesn't apply in this case, because Jesus says, I want all people. I don't care what, how big they are, how small they are, I don't care what color they are, anything else, I want them all. And that's what he meant when he said, I'm going to make you fishers again. So I hope you remember that. You don't have to throw anything back. You can remember my fish that